Well, hey there. So it is time for the 10-minute topic on the Elsa Kurt Show. I'm Elsa Kurt, and here we go. Alrighty. So a little break from the couple of topics that we've been talking about. We get a little bit personal this time around. What? Yeah. So this is actually by request. So I put a video out on TikTok. Here it is.
Hello there. I decided to record this right as the sun popped out. And now I'm kind of blind. I can't actually see a thing, but we're just going to go with it because I'm short for time here. I started a new segment on my show, The Elsa Kurt Show, and it is called The 10-Minute Topic. So every day I pick a topic and discuss it for 10 minutes. So I could use your help. Do you have any topics that you would like me to discuss, to cover? Let me know in the comments if you have some thoughts and ideas, and I appreciate it. And now I'm completely blind. And that's it.
And my friends on there did not disappoint. They came up with so many topics for me. I'm going to have material for weeks, I think, which is really, really cool. I'm really excited about that. So I appreciate all of them for commenting. And of course, if you've got an idea, you can head over to that video on TikTok and put in your two cents as well. Or you can put a comment wherever we're posting this, which would be a bunch of places. So you got lots of opportunities to give me your thoughts and ideas. So one of the ones that I saw first, one of the first ones that I saw when I went back and checked the comments, was this one right here. And I thought that would be the one that we did today, just because it's kind of fun. Like it's kind of, I never give you background. I never, it's so weird that I never talk about myself. I'm such a ham. How am I not always talking about myself? I'm really not. I'm a ham. Yes, that's an absolute. But I actually really don't like talking about myself. I like talking to other people about themselves and hearing their stories and all of that. So it's kind of weird to be sort of in the hot spot right now. But I'm going to go with it. I'm going to do it anyway. I've only got 10 minutes here and I've taken up like three of them already, giving you backstory. So here's the story, the background story. So about, let's see, 8 years ago. Is that right? Yeah, about 8 years ago, and I've told this story before, so I'm sorry if you've heard this story, but my husband and I were out to dinner one night, like we do. We have our, like our date night. It's usually like a Friday night, but we have our date night, and I know it's dorky, right? I don't care. And it's just kind of like that catching up thing. You know, the week is busy. We're both super busy all week with our stuff and things. We're both kind of like introverts. So we internalize all of our stuff. And then when we have our date night, we kind of just like purge everything. We just talk about everything that's going on, you know, whatever's on our minds, all that kind of stuff. And sometimes we get into, well, actually a lot of times I should say, really, because that's actually more accurate. We get into like these deeper conversations and it's so fun because we never know where the conversations are going to go. And that's like our favorite thing. Like we have no idea. Like we could start in one area and it goes somewhere completely different. And at the end, they're like, how did we get here? How do we start talking about this? And it's awesome. This particular night, we got into the topic of unrealized or unachieved goals or dreams and whether we had them and what they were. And so my husband asked me, you know, what's the thing that you want to do that you haven't done yet? That was kind of the gist of it. I'm going back 8 years. My memory isn't that perfect, guys. It's not perfect at all. But that's the gist of the question. And I said to him, and it's so embarrassing. Like I'm the most comfortable with my husband. Like he's my comfort place. He's my safety zone, you know, when you're playing tag, like you touch safety and that's our home base. He's home base. So, but even still, like I got like awkward. I got nervous and embarrassed. And because I never really shared this dream with anyone ever before. And I told him, he asked me that. And I said, well, I've actually always wanted to write a book. Like that's been my dream, you know, to write a book. And my husband, he's so stinking cute. My husband leaned forward and he looked me in the eye and he said, so just do it. And it's the weirdest thing. It's so weird how we hold ourselves back from doing things that we want to do. We make all kinds of excuses, right? Like all kinds of excuses. I'm too busy. I don't think I'll be good at this, you know, whatever. We just make lots of excuses. And for me, in this moment, in this specific case, it took my husband, who I, you know, trust more than anyone on the planet, whose opinion I trust entirely. And when he said that, it was actually like, I hate to use the words permission, but it was almost like getting permission to pursue something that is, you know, kind of out of the box, right? And so, yeah, so literally, the next day, I started seriously writing. Like, I've always written. I've always, ever since I was a kid, if I wasn't reading, I was writing. And if I wasn't doing either of those things, I was out climbing trees and digging in dirt and rescuing animals that probably didn't want to be rescued. And yeah, I was like a little nature kid. I still am, just not the kid, obviously. But yeah, so anyhow, I digress yet again. I started writing, and I originally started with writing a children's book. That was the first thing I wrote with intent to publish. And it was a children's book called Look Outside Your Window. And it's just a sweet, charming little rhyming story called Look Outside Your Window. And I was really excited. I went through all the steps. I self-published, put it out there in the universe on Amazon. I didn't tell a lot of people because I was still like really awkward about it. And, you know, kind of like embarrassed. And afraid. That's really the word we're looking for here. Afraid. I was afraid of what other people would say and what they would think and, you know, all of that. So, but I did it anyway. And I published that book. And I thought at the time, at that very moment when I did it, when I wrote it and published it, I thought, okay, well, I've done it now. It's the bucket list check off. I did it. And that's great. And now I'm done. Back to regular life and business. And that wasn't the case at all. That is not what happened. It opened up this floodgate of creativity, I guess, and giving myself that permission to keep going. And so I kept writing. I wrote another children's book, I think after the, yes, it was another children's book after that. It was called Ella and Her Rainbrella. So I wrote that, kept going. All the while I had this other story that had been in my head and partially in type. Yeah, I wrote it. Typed it, yeah, for years. And I decided to go ahead and tackle it. And that book was and is my first young adult book, which is called Into the Everwood. And I call that a coming of age fairy tale, modern day fairy tale. It's like I grew up with my books, really. I went from children's books to the young adult books. There's two of those. It's Into the Everwood and Lost and Found Girls. And then I decided to write a more personal fiction book, but fiction based on real life, called Livy Takes the Long Way. And that one was really hard to release because it was so personal and, you know, people would recognize themselves in it and their part in the story and things like that. So that was a really scary thing to release. And there's a whole story behind that one too. If you want to hear the story, I'm more than happy to tell you the stories. It's not that I don't want to tell you the stories. My concern always is, you know, like, I always think like, who cares, right? But if you care and you want to know, just let me know. I'm so happy to share the behind the scenes story. Now we have about 12, I think it is. I could be off a little bit. 12 like contemporary women's fiction books. Guys can read them. I don't want to exclude men from reading my books, not at all. And then my biggest accomplishment, I feel like, besides writing the very first one and actually breaking the ice and doing it, was a book series that I wrote in relatively short order for writing purposes, called Welcome to Chance. That's the series name. And I love the series and the characters in it with all of my heart. I love them so, so much. I love this town that I created. It is a fictional town called Chance, Connecticut. I'm a Connecticut girl who dreams of being a Florida girl. But yes, it's a 6-book series and it's kind of like a soap opera. It follows the lives of 5 different families. And it was so special for me to write because, like I said, I fell in love with the characters. And if you read the books, I hope you fall in love with the characters too. Full disclosure, I hate the covers. I know it's terrible to say that you hate your covers, but I do. I do, unfortunately. There's also a long story behind that too. But the Cliff Notes version of that is that my publisher picked the first 2 covers, which I hated, but I had no say in. And I had to kind of, when the rights revert back to me, I will change all of the covers on those books. So don't be fooled by the covers of those books because they don't truly represent what the series is all about. So what else? So what was the last book that I wrote? Well, the last fiction book that I wrote is called The Two Tenleys. There is a TikTok video about that one here. I'll actually just share that with you because that'll get done faster through this, I think. Here you go.
You know what she said to me?
She said, you're a player, aren't you? And I bet you got hoes. I said, you don't know me like that. I just go with the flow. She said, you can't fool me like that. You're gonna leave me on red. I said, why don't you try me on?
So again, I think every author can relate to this. I fall in love. I get so invested with the characters because they are so real. In my own crazy noggin, they're so real. And I love building these words. And yeah, and then the last book that I've published is called Welcome to the Family. That's a nonfiction book. It is Welcome to the Family, Life Behind the Thin Blue Line. And it is, it's kind of like, I hate an advice book, but it's my personal experience and observations of being in a law enforcement family, being part of the bigger picture of the law enforcement family. And I give, you know, my perspective, my insights and tips and opinions on what this lifestyle is like. And the goal of that book is to help new family members to this lifestyle, to the law enforcement family lifestyle, and shares a little bit of everything, the good, the bad, the ups, the downs, the funny, the not so funny, and wrote right from the heart. And I hope that, you know, people in our lane who read it get some help out of there or get some insights out of there that helps them. And I actually would love for people who aren't part of this family, the law enforcement family, to read this book and see what our world is like. And of course, you know, it's a generalization. Everybody's experience is a little bit different, or maybe even a lot different, but it gives you kind of like a good overview of what our universe is like. And I love anything that helps build compassion for each other and understanding. So I think that if you're not part of this world and you maybe would be interested, or maybe you just have a negative opinion of who we are and what we're like and what we stand for and all that stuff, maybe that this would give you a different idea of us. So that would be really cool in my mind. So yeah, I mean, I think that kind of like gives you the overview, the rundown. I am working on more books. I have a very last conclusion book, a sequel, I guess, a conclusion book to the Welcome to Chance series. It's going to be the 7th book in the series, and we will be revisiting Chance, but it'll be 20 years later. And it's an emotional write, this book, the whole series. Two of our main characters in the story, they're called the Brightsiders, and they're like the matriarch and patriarch of the town. And they're based on a real life couple that my husband and I have come to know and love very, very much. And I don't want to talk too much about it because I'll start crying, but it's too late. I start crying. Sorry. But we lost one of them, and in real life, of course. And it's very, so we shall see. So embarrassing. So that's that. And working on some other things that are a lot of fun. And again, apologize for the sudden tears. It happens. And thank you so much for asking about my books. Take care, guys. We'll see you in the next episode. Bye.